Now, I know I'm supposed to stand here and probably say something heartfelt, like you see in every single movie, but I'm not gonna do that. First of all, I don't wanna. Second, I'm gonna tell you, I'm done with school. First came to the decision that I wanted to quit school because, you know, I got a call from my mother and she was all like, you need to work harder, you need to try harder. But I don't want to, and I'm sick of it. I've been pushed around my entire life, told to do exactly what I want, and I am sick and tired of it.
Joey, come here for a second. We need to talk about your most recent paper. It's a little disappointing, I'm not gonna lie. You're usually doing better work than this.
Well, as far as this paper's concerned, you can go yourself.
In all fairness, I was under a lot of pressure.
Something went wrong with the door today in class. What's up with that?
Well, Chris, I'll tell you what happened during Doors class. It's pretty simple, actually. There was a moment where I just thought about everything, and I realized that I'm giving up on school. Completely stopping. Giving. Completely. Throwing in the towel. I am done. I mean, when you think about it, you spend all your time working and working and working and trying, doing crap and homework and doing tests, and nothing comes out of it. You're not going to become a doctor or a lawyer or president of the United States. Nothing comes out of it. Working at McDonald's for the rest of your life. So after I came to the conclusion that I'm not going to do anything with my life, I found out I was pretty content with it and decided to start right now, and that I'm going to stop school and not go to class or do anything. I'm starting my summer vacation from now to the day I die. Does that answer your question, Chris?
Oh, okay, man. Good luck with that. I'll see you later.
So, all I did was binge and binge and binge. I played video games, I snuck off campus, and I didn't do much of anything. But one day, after 3 months of not doing anything, When walking off campus, I met someone special.
You can't be digging out of the back of a trailer.
This is what happens when you quit school. One day you're top of the world, stocking shelves at Walgreens. The next day you're digging in a trailer for cans!
Well, actually, I kind of just quit school and, I don't know, now I'm kind of regretting it. After I see you digging around the trailer, it's kind of sad. A little pathetic, to be honest.
You're the crazy one. Your whole life's ahead of you. Don't you get it? Don't you see why? You quit school, you end up like me. You wind up, life just takes a big dumparoo. Just like it says on my trailer. With my cans. You don't want to be me. Nobody wants to be this. Their feet all cold and their boots. Because they're old and have holes in them. Because I'm getting cans. You gotta listen to me, Jimmy.
Well, I'm Joey.
It doesn't matter. You need to get back to school. That's where you belong. Go! Go to your home!
I mean, you're kind of right. Although you are insanely smelly and kind of creepy in a way. You're right. You can go back to school. I'm gonna make something of myself. I'm not gonna become you and, you know, probably killed somebody or something like that. I don't know. But I'm gonna go back. You'll see. You're right. Thank you, homeless man!
And after the talk with the hobo, I soon realized I was on my way back to school.
Run, Jimmy! Oh, I forgot to ask him for money. Dang it. When you find out
much later that they don't. Guys!
Joey,
no,
you're not dead!
No, I'm not dead. I just took a break for a while.
I'm glad you're not dead.
Before I knew it, everything went back to normal. Well, as normal as usual. Oh shit, there's a bear. Could you hand me that shotgun, buddy? Also that chair.
Say a prayer for me, 'cause it's rare.